Hi, do you grind your teeth? We want to put an end to that. A lot of people gnash their teeth these days. Why is that? Well, because you literally can't open your mouth wide enough anymore. Because the moment you chew soft food and don't need to open your mouth wide to eat your food, opening at a wide angle, that is, then your chewing force is reduced over time, and you'll come to a point when more and more of the tension is locked in there that wants to be released. Plus, the job that you have, in the truest sense of the word, is to keep your mouth shut and bear it. That happens to a lot of people. To keep their jobs, to stay together as a couple, to solve the problems that bother them, keep their mouth shut, grin and bear it. That's a reoccurring theme nowadays. And so, during the night, your teeth, your chewing muscles, are so tensed up, under pressure, if you will, they kind of act out. And then you start grinding your teeth, wearing them down. Lots of people have to wear a mouth guard or teeth protectors at night to stop the effects of this destructive habit. But we can also resolve the situation in a different way. Ina, please take a seat. So, what do we have to do to release the tension so that at some point you can lose the mouth guard and live without it? Well, you have to open your mouth. Ina, place your chin into the triangle of thumb and index finger and open your mouth. This is only about opening your mouth more and more. You can put your other hand on your forehead to keep your head from moving forward. Tilt your head back a bit to prevent saliva from dribbling out, or do the exercise in the shower. Keep opening your mouth, and soon enough you'll notice a rather pronounced stretch in your cheeks. It really hurts. Not beyond 10 on your personal pain scale, but above 8. Do that for 2 and a half minutes. Keep your mouth open, increase the angle more, and that's basically it. That reduces that gnashing, this cracking sound from your jaw joint. Simply open your mouth wide every day for 2 and a half minutes, and then close it again. And now, I'm recommending something special for you. Take this ball and place it here, right against this angle. Take it, place it yourself, Ina. Feel for the angle along the jawline, here and here, and that's exactly where you place the ball. Find the spot where you're most tender and press against it. And if you have two of them, you can work on both sides simultaneously. Saves you time, releasing even more of the tension in there. And you'll feel so much better afterwards, and you'll be able to open your mouth even wider. And it's going to be much easier to move it. Thanks, Ina. If you like this exercise and it helped you, give us a thumbs up, recommend us to others, and above all, pass on the knowledge, because this problem, grinding your teeth, bothers a lot of people with tensions in the jaw. You can tell it's everybody, and they will all benefit from it. You can do the same exercise, not with your hand, but with a cork. Yeah? Whittle a cork to a size that allows you to just put it between your teeth, and then put it in your mouth over the course of a day so that your mouth is in this open position. At some point, take a new cork to adjust to an even larger angle to solve the problem, and you could throw away the mouth guard, your teeth protector. And that'll put a permanent end to your problem. Don't stop with the exercises. Thank you for watching, and see you soon.